Okay, so in this video, we will see the calculation in transformer. We will talk about the exercise that I have uploaded in Google Classroom. Let's start with this question. We find there are 120 at the input. Let's just put it here, 120. And in the input. And then, how much is the output? We know that the ratio between the coil will be equal to the ratio of the voltage. So, the ratio of the voltage equal to the ratio of the coil. Or if you want to use this formula, it's fine. Okay, logically, 800 compared with 40, it is 20 compared with 1, right? So the ratio will be 20 compared with 1. And the ratio of the voltage should also be the same. Input and output should also be the same, so it will be 6 volt. Now the ratio is the same, 20 compared with 1. Or if you want to use this formula, it's also okay. N means the amount of coil for the primary, and S is the amount of coil at the secondary. It means at the output. Just put 800 compared with 40 equal to 120 compared with this. And then we can get the result, also the same, 6 volt. Next, question B asks about the current. Okay, the concept is in transformer only change the voltage. It doesn't change the energy and power because no one can create energy from nothing. We can only change the form, and the same thing happen in transformer. So the energy at the input or the power in the input will be equal to the energy at the output in ideal condition. In reality, the energy will be decreased because some energy loss become heat or loss to surrounding. But in ideal condition, like in question B, in ideal condition, so in ideal condition, the power or the energy, in this case we use power, in the input will be equal with the power at the output. And we know from the concept of power, electric power equal to voltage times with current. Voltage times with current. So voltage in and current in the input will be equal with the voltage and current at the output. Now we can just put the number here. The voltage is 120 and the current is 2 ampere from the question. And at the output, it is the voltage will be 6 volt. This is from question A, and the current will be, yeah, just finish this equation, 240 watt equal to 6 times with I, so the I will be 240 divided by 6, so it will be 40 ampere. So the current at the input will be 40 ampere. Okay. That's 40 ampere. Now, this is the ideal condition when the power input equal to power output. But in reality, this like I told you, there is no ideal transformer. And then, like in question C, what happens if there are 50% efficiency? Yeah, 50% efficiency means there is half of the power or energy lost to the surrounding, lost become heat. For example, 70% efficiency means there are 30% energy that is lost, become heat. So how to calculate question C if it's not ideal? It means the power at the beginning when it's in ideal condition, the power will be, we can see here, the power is 240. So it will be 240 in the input and also 240 in the output in ideal condition. But in the case of 50% efficiency, it means 50% of this being lost to the surrounding. So the power output will not be the same, will not be 240, but it will become 120, half, 50%. Okay, so now we can change the equation. Voltage times with current equal to 100, this one. The voltage is not changed, it's still 6 volt because we know the concept of transformer is changing the voltage based on the ratio of the coil. And because the coil is still 840, it means the voltage will also be, the ratio will also the same. So this will not be changed, it's still 6 volt. The one that it changed is the current. So in this case, 6 volt times with current equal to 120 watt. So we get the current to be 20 ampere. So the answer for question C is 20 ampere. That's how you solve the problem with transformer with efficiency. Okay, if you want to make this into a question, so let's see, the power input equal to the power output, this is for ideal. Now if let's use this 70% efficiency, it means the power input will not be equal, but the power at the output will only be 70%, will only be a part of the input. So it only be 70% of the input. So power output equal to power input times with 70%. Or if you want to make into a general equation, we can change this into like efficiency. The symbol for efficiency is I forgot the name. Let's search first. Eta, something like this. Nah, this is the symbol for efficiency times with power input. Okay. Okay, this symbol is called eta. It means the efficiency. Okay, there you go. Okay, if the question is the efficiency, like for example number 10 in the exercise, calculate efficiency, it means you just need to use this formula. A transformer generate 5 ampere and 12 volt. Okay, from here we can find the power. This is at its output, but this is the power output. Voltage time with current, so 60 watt. And then the primary coil connected to 100 volt and 1 ampere. Primary mean input, so we can find the power input will be 100 watt. Well, actually, without using the formula, using logic, we can see that the output only 60% of 100, so the efficiency should be 60%. But if you use the formula, in case the number is not this good, we can use this formula. For example, episode kita di efisiensi times with power input we get 100 equals to 60. So we get the efficiency equals to 60 divided by 100 and we will get 0.6. If you want to make it into percentage, so we can multiply it with 100. So we get the efficiency is 60%. Okay, that's how you solve this question. Thank you for listening this video.